Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
Captain's log, stardate 45021.3. Convincing Starfleet Command to establish a blockade was relatively painless. Implementing that plan is proving more troublesome.
Starfleet is stretched pretty thin across this quadrant. There are only about 12 ships within a day's travel of this position.
The only other ships available are either in space dock for repairs or still under construction. Most of them don't even have full crews yet.
We could probably scare up 7, maybe 8 more ships.
Miss LaForge, can you implement your tachyon detection grid with 20 ships?
It's possible, but the more ships, the bigger the net we can throw.
All right. I want to add the Tiananmen, the Sutherland, and the Hermes, whether the yacht superintendent says they're ready or not. Mr. Data, will you select a group of experienced Enterprise officers to augment the crews of those ships?
Aye, sir.
Will, I want you to command the Excalibur. Her crew was reassigned when she put in for repairs. Geordi, you will be his first officer.
Aye, sir.
I want the fleet underway by 0900 tomorrow. Thank you, gentlemen. Yes, Mr. Data.
May I ask a question, sir, of a personal nature?
Yes.
I am confused. Why have I not been assigned to command a ship in the fleet, sir?
Well, I felt that you would be needed here. Why do you ask?
You have commented on the lack of senior officers available for this mission. I believe my 26 years of Starfleet service qualifies me for such a post. However, if you do not feel the time has arrived for an android to command a starship, perhaps I should address myself to improving...
Commander. I believe the starship Sutherland will need a captain. I think of no one better suited for that task than you.
Thank you, sir.
Did have fools working for you, Lars. Now you don't have as many.
Hey, you were lucky, Kern. But luck always runs out. Someday I will stand over your broken corpse and drink to the victory of the Duras.
Ah, Worf, good. This piece of buck-tom is Captain Lars. He commanded a squadron that tried to destroy us yesterday.
Ah, the infamous Worf, son of Moog. What is that you are wearing? That is a uniform of a Klingon!
The capital city is neutral ground, and Lars' men are all around us, as are mine.
Gonna drink with you, Kern. May you die well.
Die well, Lars. Huh?
Drink with our enemies?
How many are Gowrins, men? How many are Duras? Does it matter? When we meet in battle, we will fight to the death. But here, we're all warriors, all Klingons.
The repairs to the Hektar are proceeding. The port stabilizer...
Is there nothing in your heart but duty?
It is my responsibility.
We all have responsibilities and duties. But you and I are warriors fighting in a great war. Think of it. You and I will fight battles that others can only dream of. The time for glory is here. It is not a time to worry about stabilizers. It is a time to celebrate. But tomorrow we all may die. God, let us, the sons of Moog, live this night as if it were our last.
Worf is not like his brother.
No, he tries to be. But he's still unsure of himself.
Perhaps he needs something to help restore his confidence.
I think he'll find our offer appealing.
I'll make sure he does.
lots of beans, lots of beans, all beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, lots of beans, yeah.
I love beans, diggity doo.